Hello, Melvin.
Hi, good evening, teacher.
How are you?
Good.
How was your day?
Oh, very short, teacher.
You didn't work much?
Oh, yes, every day.
How many hours do you work?
Around 11.
That's a long journey.
Yes, but it's my fault because I start 2 hours
before,
and I go out 1 hour later.
And why do you do that?
Because there's a lot of
work. Extra work.
There's a lot of work, teacher.
Okay.
I work with customers.
Okay.
Where do you work, Melvin?
DLC, gas station.
Yes.
But in the central office, I am a marketing consultant.
Oh, so you are in the administrative area.
Yes, I have a charge of government. Government counts.
Oh, okay.
Yes.
Yeah, so that must be a lot of work.
Yes, in this moment, all the government makes a plan de contingencia.
Yeah.
And starts a lot of new activities, irregular activities, and it requires my attention, my special attention.
Exactly, I understand. Okay. Yes. And where is the office located?
In Santa Elena.
Okay. Good. Good.
Behind the Holiday Inn Hotel.
Okay. Good. Good.
Yes.
All right. Well, thank God you have work. Because
yes,
many people are looking for work.
Yes. Yes, teacher. I work for 10 years in the company.
Okay. Good. Yes. Good. All right. Okay, everybody, welcome back.
Hello, everybody.
Melvin, Cecilia, Nelly, and Alma. How was your day? Fine, Francisco. Good. Nice. Good. Tired. Good, good. So you're going to get some sleep when we finish the class. All right. What's today's date?
Is March 19?
Exactly, March 19th. What year?
2020.
That is correct, 2020. Yes. So if, today is the 19th. Do you remember the topics we covered yesterday?
Imperatives? No.
Yeah, imperatives, right, right.
Imperatives.
Can you give me examples of imperatives? Go outside, close the door, be quiet, go upstairs.
Don't work too hard.
Don't work too hard, yes.
Don't use cell phones.
Don't use your cell phone. Look, this is one of my sons.
Oh, hello.
Say hello.
Hello.
Say hello, people.
Nice to meet.
Hello, people. That's my son. He's the last one. All right. So imperatives are orders. Imperatives are instructions that you need to follow. How do you say no se desvele in English?
I don't know.
Do you remember how to say quedarse?
Stay.
How do you say que? Ajá, stay.
Stay.
Si le agregamos la preposición up, ya cambia el significado y dice desvelarse. Stay up. Stay up. Exactly. Go with your mama. Okay, so can you give me other examples of imperatives? Questions? Para los que estuvieron ausentes ayer, si usted da una instrucción, un comando, solamente ocupa el verbo en su forma natural. How do you say cierre la puerta, please?
Close the door.
Close the door.
Close the door.
Yeah, close the door, please. How do you say lávese las manos?
Wash your hands.
Wash your hands. How do you say empiece a cocinar?
Start cooking.
Very good. So, como usted se fija, start cooking, wash your hands, open the door. Para dar un comando, una instrucción, simplemente ocupamos el verbo.
Okay.
What's the form if the command is negative, if the imperative is negative? How do you say no fume?
Don't smoke.
Don't. ¿Cuáles son las recomendaciones del gobierno? No salga. How do you say no salga in English?
Don't go out.
How do you say no se dé la mano?
Don't shake your hands.
Very good. Don't shake hands. Don't shake hands. No hay que andar saludando de mano en estos momentos. ¿Cómo han recomendado saludar?
Codo.
Exactly. Así ve.
Codo.
Entonces, cuando usted mire a su jefe, a su jefa, así salúdela, así bien juvenil. Ok, so, si la instrucción que usted esté dando es negativa, siempre le tiene que poner don't. How do you say no tome bus? No tome bus.
Don't take the bus.
También puede decir catch. Don't catch the bus. Don't take the bus.
Don't catch the bus.
Yeah, don't catch the bus. How do you say tome taxi?
Take the taxi.
Take the taxi.
Exactly. Take a taxi.
Take a taxi. Take a taxi.
Yes. Nelly, can you hear me? Permítame que Nelly me está preguntando. Give me one second. No sé por qué no me sale el chat. But anyways, si alguien puede hablar con yo sí, dice. Yo no, Nelly. Ok, anyways. All right, quizás solo le va a tocar estar escuchando ahora. Nelly, si usted me escucha, revise su headset. Tal vez algo tiene malo. All right. Any other questions? Any comments about commands, imperatives? ¿Cuáles son los famosos consejos que siempre le está dando usted a su hijo o a su hija?
Wash the hands.
Wash your hands. What else? How do you say no hable con extraños?
Don't speak.
Yes, don't speak with strangers.
With strangers.
Yes. How do you say no acepte invitaciones de desconocidos? En Facebook.
No.
Don't accept invitations from strangers. How do you say llámeme cuando llegue?
Call me when
you
you
call me when you
call me when
you arrive. Yes, arrive. Call me when you arrive. Llámeme cuando llegue.
Call me.
Call me when you arrive.
Call me when you arrive.
Ajá. ¿Qué otro consejo le da a sus hijos? Nadie me ha dicho nada o no los aconsejan.
Sí. Studying, please.
Exactly. Come on, study. This is not vacation.
Come in here.
Good. Very good.
Eat your vegetables.
Eat your vegetables. Very good.
Come in here. Wash the dishes, please. No, I don't, Mom.
Mire, y lo oyen como que es una un gran castigo.
Sí.
So, oh, why me? Okay, any questions? Any questions about imperatives? Ese es algo que se ocupa muy seguido. Cuando usted le dice a alguien qué hacer o qué no hacer. Any questions before we start? No? Okay. Now, we have two different activities for today. But before we start, do you remember the class with medicaments?
Yes.
Can you give me examples of medicine that we use when you go to the doctors?
The aspirin.
Aspirin.
Only number.
Only the name. Only the name.
Only the name.
Aspirin. Yes, Cecilia. Muscle cream. Can you mention examples of muscle cream? Acuérdense, los que se perdieron la clase de los medicamentos, ahí está en el canal de YouTube. Es decir, cualquier clase que usted se haya perdido, váyase al canal y ahí está en, grabada lo que hemos hecho.
Okay, thanks.
What else? What else? What else? ¿Qué más?
Eye drops.
Exactly. What is the function of the eye drop?
Eye irritation.
Good. If you have irritation in your eyes, you put eye drops. Yes. If you have an allergy. What else? ¿Qué me recomienda si yo estoy?
Cough syrup.
Yes, cough syrup. Cough syrup. Yes.
Cough syrup.
Se han conectado varios que andaban perdidos. Estaban secuestrados, ¿o qué?
No.
Okay, so those are medicaments. Aspirin, cough syrup. Si son los dulcitos para la tos, ¿cómo se le llama? What's the name?
Cough drops.
Y esa última palabra es la misma que se ocupa para decir gotas de los ojos. Eye drops, cough drops.
Eye drops.
Cuando, antes de que usted haga los ejercicios del platform, si se le perdió, si usted no estuvo en la clase del martes, vaya a ver la clase del martes. Si no estuvo en la clase de ayer, vaya a ver la clase de ayer para cuando llegue a los ejercicios se le hace más fácil todo. Any other examples of medicines?
Cold pills.
Yes. Can you give me examples of cold pills? In El Salvador.
Tapsin.
Yes.
Virogrip.
Panadol. Exactly. Panadol en Salvador. Yes.
Any questions about medicine? Ahora, esas son las medicinas. A ver, ¿cuándo es que usted toma todas esas medicinas? Ahora dígame las enfermedades.
When have
headache.
When have stomach ache.
Okay, good. When you have a stomach ache. Aquí les pongo en el chat la palabra y se pronuncia. ¿Cómo dijimos que se pronunciaba?
What?
Lo que le acabo de poner en el chat de WhatsApp. Ache. Se pronuncia ache.
Ache. Ache.
So
ache.
How do you say dolor de cabeza?
Headache.
¿Dolor de dientes?
Toothache.
¿Dolor de estómago?
Stomachache.
¿Dolor de espalda?
Backache.
Yes. ¿Y cuando lo deja a su novia? ¿Dolor de qué tienen?
Heartache.
You say, my heart aches. My heart aches. All right. Any questions about the medicine or the illness? No? Okay. Today we start with a new topic. The topic is related with places in your, how do you say vecindario in English?
Neighborhood.
Exactly. Vecindario is neighborhood. Vecino is neighbor. Yes. Can you mention places in your neighborhood? Like supermarket, bank.
Gas station.
Post office.
Church.
Very good.
The hospital,
yes.
The beach.
In your neighborhood. Bueno, si vive en el puerto, sí.
The park.
¿Cómo se sienten?
Volcano.
The volcano in your neighborhood?
Coffee.
Volcano.
Bueno, si vive ahí en el Boquerón, sí. Volcano.
Restaurants.
Cafeterias.
Supermarkets.
Uh-huh. How do you say, Cecilia? Huh? I can't hear you. How do you say panadería in English? How do you say panadero?
Baker.
Very good. Panadero, you say
baker.
Is panadero. Panadería bakery. Is bakery. Yes,
bakery.
What can you buy in a bakery?
Bread.
Only bread? Croissants? Cake?
Candy bar?
Yeah, and sometimes they sell candy bars. Yes. Okay, anything else?
Cookies,
yes. All right. Y los que no han dicho nada, ¿dónde vivirán?
Sweet bread.
Okay, sweet bread. Oh my God, so delicious.
Yeah.
Yeah, but bad for the sugar. All right. So let me show you, how do you say imagen in English?
Image.
So let me show you an image.
Teacher.
Yes, sir.
What do you say? Estación de policía o policía.
Police station.
Pero,
police station. Yeah, police station. Yes.
Police station.
Okay, do you see the picture?
Yes.
How many places?
Bank.
Okay, but how many places? How many?
Eight places.
What is the first place?
The bank.
A bank.
Can you give me examples of banks in El Salvador?
Scotiabank.
Okay, good. Now let me ask you, what transactions can you do in a bank? What transactions?
Save money.
Cash, check.
Deposit.
Credit.
Pay credit, or ask for credit. How do you say pedir in English?
Ask.
Si usted quiere reconstruir su casa, usted dice ask for credit. Pero si ya se lo dieron, you pay the credit.
Pay the credit.
Okay. Can you make deposits?
Yes.
Can you pay bills?
Yes.
Okay. What is the opposite of deposit? The opposite. What is the word in Spanish? It's in your chat, in the WhatsApp chat.
Withdraw.
Withdraw quiere decir retirar.
Withdraw.
Usted llega del cajero y le dice, welcome to bank, whatever, how can I help you? Y usted le dice, I want to withdraw money. Quiero retirar dinero. Withdraw.
Okay.
Other transactions that you can do in the bank.
Pay credit cards.
Yes. Very good. Okay. What about the second picture? What is the place?
A drugstore.
What can you do in a drugstore?
Buy medicine.
Algunas solo se las van a vender con receta. How do you say receta in English? Lo vimos el día de las...
Prescription.
Exactly. Prescription. Very good. Prescription. Y ahí está en el chat otra vez. Prescription. ¿Y si es de comida?
Recipe.
Very good. If it's medicine, it's prescription. If it's food, it's recipe. Okay, what
repeat,
else?
Please.
Sure, prescription is for medicine. Ahí está en el chat.
Sí.
And recipe es siempre receta, pero de comida. Ahí están los dos.
Okay. Thank you.
Sure. So tenga cuidado. No va a llegar a una farmacia diciendo, I have the recipe.
What?
Huevo frito.
Cara de chef me vio, le dice. Okay. So when you go to a drugstore, you buy medicine, you show the prescription. But they have additional services. Can you mention the additional services they have?
Poner una inyección.
Ajá. Put injections. Ajá. Hoy que está esta gran bulla del rotavirus, del coronavirus. Coronavirus. ¿Qué es lo que le hacen al llegar si usted le dice que no se siente muy bien?
Le miden la temperatura.
Ajá.
Make a temperature.
Okay, they take your temperature.
They Take.
Y también puede ocupar la palabra medir, que es measure, pero aplica más el take. Take my temperature.
Take my temperature.
Okay. Can you pay bills?
Yes.
Yes.
Sure.
In some sure
you can. Sir, yes.
Yes, okay. Exactly. Very good. All right. Picture number three.
Post office.
Post office. What can you do in a post office?
The car letter.
Send letters.
Send letters.
Packet.
Package. Very good.
Send letters.
Send letters or package. Yes.
Package.
Mm-hmm. Estampillas.
Aha. How do you say estampillas in English? Stamps.
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 Stamps. Ahí está escrito. Stamps. Stamps.
Stamps.
Stamps.
Stamps.
¿Ya han oído algunas direcciones en Estados Unidos que dicen P.O. Box?
Yes.
¿Qué significará ese P.O. Box?
Es como el apartado postal.
Ajá, pero no, ¿cuándo lo aplica?
Es la... postal, o sea,
¿qué es un P.O. Box? ¿Quién ocupa un P.O. Box ahí en Estados Unidos? ¿Alguien que no tiene un domicilio fijo? ¿O si lo tiene, no lo quiere compartir, no lo quiere hacer público? Entonces ellos van a las oficinas postales, habilitan literalmente un locker, un casillero, lo que sea, y ¿cómo se llama? No necesariamente tiene que ser físico, pero ahí le llega toda la correspondencia.
Ok.
P.O. Box. P.O. Box.
P.O. Box.
Yes, P.O. Box. A gas station. What do you do in a gas station?
Fuel your car.
Good. You fuel your car. You put gasoline. Or you put fuel. You can say gasoline, you can say fuel.
Sorry, fuel. Teacher.
Yes, sir.
You know the next Monday, the price of the gasoline going down 35 cents.
Really?
Yes. La tendencia is down.
Oh, really? Oh,
yes.
That's good news, and we need
35 cents each gallon.
That's significant.
Yes, yes.
That's good news.
Yes.
That's good. So what are the three types of fuel that you can put in your car? The three types of fuel.
Special.
Yes.
Regular.
And regular.
Diesel. Okay.
Very good. Special, regular, and diesel.
Diesel.
Yes. ¿Cómo se le llama eso? Combustible. How do you say combustible in English? Fuel.
Fuel.
Ahí está en el chat. Fuel.
Fuel.
Yes. Fuel. All right. So we have a gas station. Okay. Restaurant.
Restaurant.
Mm-hmm. What can you do in a restaurant?
Cook.
Okay. Do you cook or do you eat?
Eat.
Right.
Eat.
Well, if you work in the restaurant, you cook. But if you are the customer, you eat.
Eat.
Right? What is your favorite restaurant?
Tony Roma's.
Tony Roma's. Uh-huh.
Olive Garden to me.
Olive Garden. Very good. What else? ¿Qué más?
A Cajutla restaurant.
Very good. Nice. What else? Los demás, no. You don't like restaurants? Choris?
Pollo campero.
Pollo campero.
Yeah. Puerto Marisco.
Puerto Marisco, my goodness. Cold beer.
El Zócalo.
Okay, good. Very good.
Campo.
Yeah, okay. So we have different ones. Acajutla, Tony Romas. Dennis is good. Dennis is nice.
Dennis is good.
Yeah.
It's Dennis delicious. The breakfast.
Sure. The hamburgers are good too.
Yes.
¿Alguno de ustedes vive en Merliot o en Santa Tecla?
Me in Villa del Mar.
Okay. Have you visited Mike's Burger in Merliot?
Yes.
¿Alguien de ustedes ha ido a Mike's Burger?
Yes, I was.
Yes.
Did you like it?
Yes, but the hamburger has very big.
Yeah.
Yes. Yeah.
Mire, vale el combo casi lo que vale un Burger King o un Wendy's de los buenos. Pero mire, le dan un combo tan grande que pueden comer dos personas.
Really nice.
And the hamburger is good. The yes. hamburger is good.
The meat where? Is really good.
On Chiltiupan. Chiltiupan. On Chiltiupan.
Charlie's Burger or
Charlie Boy.
Charlie Boy.
No, Charlie's Burger. Charlie Boy is different.
Is this
is another restaurant?
Yeah, it's another Charlie restaurant.
Boy.
Yes, it's another restaurant. Okay, next picture, a bookstore.
Bookstore.
How do you say bookstore? How do you say bookstore in Spanish?
Librería.
Exactly. Very good. So, what can you do in a bookstore?
Buy the book.
Buy the books.
Buy
book. Material.
Buy the review.
Paper.
Buy the pen.
Okay, paper, pen.
Accesorios.
That is called. Oh my God! What is that word? I mean, you say accessories, but
accessories.
I'm trying to think. Oh, stationery.
Stationery.
Stationery is papelería in general.
Hey,
okay.
Okay.
What about this picture here?
Department store.
Department store.
Okay. Can you give me examples of department stores in El Salvador?
Simon.
Sears.
Numbers.
Yes. Okay. Very good. And the last one, a supermarket.
Market.
What can you buy in the supermarket?
Eggs, meat, fruit, cereal, yes.
sugar,
rice.
Everything.
Beans.
Everything for your house. Right? What's the name of this? Ya lo vimos. What's the name?
Alcohol.
Ahí le voy otra vez. It's going again to your chat. La curva, la calaca. Okay. You lost me. Y se lleva dedicación. You lost me. Sanitizer.
Okay.
So this is sanitizer.
Sanitizer.
Do you use sanitizer?
Yes.
What is the function of the sanitizer?
Kill the bacteria.
Good. Kill bacteria. Germs. Kill bacteria and germs. And now it's very, very important that people use sanitizers. Yes. All right. Any questions here? Questions, questions?
No?
No
okay. Question.
Now, can you mention additional places in your neighborhood? ¿Alguno que no esté aquí en estas fotos?
Church.
Convenience store.
Convenience store, church, hospital.
Airport.
Airports.
Town hall.
What is it?
Town hall, alcaldía.
City hall.
City hall.
City hall. Ahí le he escrito. City hall.
City hall.
Ah, sí.
City hall means alcaldía. City hall. Anything else? Any other places? ¿Algún otro
lugar? Cinema.
Parks. Yes, parks. Definitely.
Cinema.
Cinema, sure. Sure, okay. Cinemas. Okay, clinics.
The hospital.
Casinos, yes, casinos. Hospitals, clinics. Mm-hmm. How do you say mercado in English?
Market.
Market. Exactly, very good. Vet, sure. Yeah, you need a hospital for animals too.
Yes.
Anything else?
School.
Yeah, sure. School, academies, universities. What happens if you
jail?
Yes, there is a jail. A los chicos malos. Yes. Jail. Uh-huh. Now, where do you take your car if it's giving you a problem? Yeah, the gym. The gym is very important. Okay, if your car is giving you problems, where do you take it? If your car is giving you problems, where do you take it? To the mechanic, right. And yeah. What's the name of the place where the mechanic works?
Workshop.
Picture.
Auto shop.
Repair.
Auto shop. Auto shop.
Auto shop.
Yes.
There.
Yeah, auto shop.
Okay.
Auto shop.
Yes, auto shop. And who works in the auto shop? The mechanic.
Okay.
All right. Any additional places?
Church.
Yes, a church. Definitely.
A car wash. A car wash.
Yeah, car wash are very popular right now.
Yes.
Do you take your car to a car wash or do you do it?
I go to the car wash.
You go to the car wash. Okay. Fine, si no hay tiempo, cabal, toque ir a dejarlo al car wash.
But sometimes in the house, it's relaxing.
Sure, yeah, and you save money.
Yes, too.
Yeah, I think that in 15 or 20 minutes, you wash your car.
Yes.
Uh-huh. Good question. How do you say ferretería in English?
I don't know.
Hardware store.
Hardware store.
Yes, hardware store.
Hardware store.
Ferretería. Y hardware, en ese caso, no tiene nada que ver con computadoras, porque usted se acuerda que aparece software y hardware, pero no tiene nada que ver. Hardware store. Can you give me examples of hardware stores in El Salvador?
Freon.
Freon, yes.
Vidri.
Epa.
Epa. Epa, exactly. All right. Anything else? Any questions about this picture?
No.
Los voy a poner a trabajar en parejas. Ahí está la imagen. Ya se las envié al chat también. Entonces usted le va a preguntar a su compañero, what can you do in a bank? Esa es la pregunta que usted le va a hacer a su compañero. What can you do in a bank? Y su compañero le va a responder y vamos a practicar todo lo que hemos estado viendo. So, si digamos yo estuviese hablando con Nelly y yo le digo, Nelly, what can... Oh, Nelly no puede hablar, ¿verdad? Ok, si yo digo a María, María, what can you do in a bank? What would be your answer?
What...
What can you do in a bank?
I go.
Alguien que diga qué puede hacer en un in a bank.
I go pay the bills.
Yes. All right. Yes, you pay the bills. Ok, para los que están teniendo mala señal y todo, acuérdense que ahorita Zoom está con una demanda exagerada, entonces hay veces que colapsa la señal porque hay mucha gente, literalmente hay miles de personas conectadas.
Sí, de universities.
Exactly. Ok, so I'm going to put you in pairs, voy a poner a trabajar en parejas, vamos a ocupar estas imágenes, ya la tienen en el teléfono. Y usted va a decir, what can you do in a bank? What can you do in a gas station? What can you do? Y ahí va mencionándolos todos. So, here we go. Break rooms. 7 people. We'll make 3 pairs. Create rooms. Let's go.
Hola.
Hello, hello.
Hi.
Are you practicing?
Teacher, solo yo estoy conectado.
Oh, es que Nelly tenía problemas, es cierto. Ok, give me a second. Ya la voy a cambiar de pareja, Cecilia. I'm sorry.
Ok.
Hi, Cecilia.
Hi, Maria Lisa.
How are you?
I'm fine. You?
I'm fine.
Okay. Me habían enlazado con la compañera que me escucha, entonces me acaban de...
Post office. A tree. What do you do at post office?
I'm going to send a letter.
Send a letter. Y recibir, ¿cómo será? Porque también es enviar y recibir.
Receive.
Receive.
Receive a letter. A package. Letter.
Send and receive letter.
Yes.
Send and receive letter.
Okay. What do you do at a gas station?
I'm going to
eat the breakfast. Mm-hmm. Okay. What can you do in a... Es que no se ven las imágenes. A post office. Post
office. I go in package.
Package. Okay.
Drugstore is number two.
Drugstore.
I go buy pills.
Are you practicing?
Yes.
Yes.
Maria Lisa asked me, teacher.
Hi.
Okay. So practice.
Hi. What can you do in the...
Yes.
Okay.
Okay.
Image 7, no puedo ver bien el nombre, como dice.
Department store.
Ah, department store.
Yeah, department store.
What are you do department store?
Can buy a cloth.
You can buy shoes.
Okay.
Pants.
Okay.
Pants.
You can buy some home products. I don't know.
Yes, home products. That is home correct.
Products. Okay.
Right.
And last.
Okay, image 8. What do the super market.
Mm-hmm. What can you do in a supermarket?
Can buy anything. Milk. Meats. And.
Teacher, why is groceries?
Groceries is everything in general for your house.
Food. Only food.
Food, sanitizer, toilet paper, soap, things that you use in your house.
Okay. It's products in general.
Yeah, products in general, exactly. Okay. All right, so let's return.
Esta cosa se queda muda.
Did you finish practicing?
Yes, I finished practice.
Okay, good. Do you have any do you have any questions? Everything is clear?
Yes.
Okay, so let me show you this. Do you see that picture? Do you see the picture?
No.
No.
You don't see anything?
Anything.
Okay, let me check. Share. Do you see the image?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. What do you see in the picture?
Conversation.
Conversation.
Okay, there is a conversation. And do you see the picture?
Empire State Building.
Uh-huh.
Big building, very tall building.
Yeah, big building. Do you know the name of the building?
The man is tourist.
Exactly. How do you know he's a tourist?
Because they have a guy. Uh-huh.
Okay. Alguien está cocinando, se oye la cuchara, la pailita.
Todo.
Póngalo en silencio para que no nos dé hambre a nosotros.
Okay. Lavando los trastes está allá.
Ah, castigados están. Sí. Ok.
So, hombre sumiso.
Ok, exactly.
Nice.
That's good. How do you know the man is a tourist? How do you know? ¿Cómo saben que es turista el chico que está en la foto? How do you know?
For the camera.
The camera.
Uh-huh. Okay, so...
Because he's lost.
Exactly, he's lost. Esa es una señal. El turista generalmente pregunta, mira, ¿dónde te queda tal cuestión? Now, what does he have in his hands? What does he have in his hands?
A tourist book?
Maybe. Yes, maybe a map. Do you see the name of the book?
New York.
New York.
New York. Yes. Where is New York?
Where is New York? In United States.
East Coast or West Coast?
What is question?
En la costa este. East or west?
I don't know.
Correcto, es en la costa este. East Coast.
East Coast.
California is on the other side. It's West Coast. Okay. So, how many people in the conversation?
Two people.
Ok. Lo voy a leer una vez. Usted póngale atención y mire si hay alguna palabra que no reconoce o necesita pronunciar bien. Here we go. Excuse me, ma'am. Can you help me? How do I get to St. Patrick's Cathedral? Just walk up Fifth Avenue to 50th Street. St. Patrick's is on the right. Is it near Rockefeller Center? Yes. It's right across from Rockefeller Center. Thank you. And where's the Empire State Building? Is it far from here? It's right behind you. Just turn around and look up. ¿Ya les ha pasado eso?
Sí. Está perdido atrás los pies.
Mira, ¿dónde es el Banco Agrícola? Le pregunta al guardia. Pase adelante y le dice. Oh. Okay. Any questions about pronunciation or meaning?
Yes, teacher.
What is ma'am?
Ma'am. Does anybody know the meaning of ma'am?
Ma'am.
Es la forma respetuosa de dirigirse a una mujer. Excuse me, ma'am.
Ah, okay. Excuse me, ma'am.
Decir madre.
Ma'am. Ma'am.
Disculpe,
ma'am. Ajá.
Madame.
Mire, madre.
No, madrán, no.
Aquí es madre. Aquí
es madre.
Ajá. Mire, madre, perdón.
Exactly. Yeah, but it's not madre, it's ma'am.
Ma'am.
Excuse me, ma'am. Yes. What else?
Excuse me.
Catedral.
Cathedral.
Cathedral.
Yes, cathedral.
Cathedral.
Yes, cathedral.
Draw. Okay.
Yes, cathedral. Cathedral.
Cathedral.
Okay.
Cathedral. Yep. Cathedral. Anything else?
Rockefeller Music. Where is he? He's from here, right behind.
Okay, so if you don't have any questions, I need two volunteers to read the dialogue. I need the tourist and I need the woman. Volunteers?
I'm the tourist teacher.
Very good. Thank you, Melvin. And who's the woman?
Yeah, teacher.
Okay, thank you. Lights, camera, action.
Excuse me, mom. Can you help me? How do I get to St. Patrick's Cathedral?
Uh-huh.
Yes. Voila.
Walk up.
I walk up 5 Avenue to 60th Street.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, St. Patrick's is on the right.
Is it near Rockefeller Center?
Yes, it's right, across from Rockefeller Center.
Thank you. And where is the Empire State Building? It is far from here?
It's right behind you. Just turn around and look up.
All right, very good. Any questions?
No question.
Okay, so we're going to stop here. Take care of yourselves, follow instructions, use sanitizer, use water and soap, and pray to God.
Yes. Principal.
Yeah, that's the most important. Yes. Speak with God and He can give us protection.
Yes, sure.
All right, so have a nice weekend. I will see you Monday, same place, same time.
Yes.
Good night.
Good night. Everybody. See you later Monday.
Bye-bye.